Alright, so the first of our Xbox Live Arcade demos here is Sea Life Safari. Snap pics of underwater sea life in this kid-friendly adventure. And I guess that's all there is to it. Sounds like fun. I mean, I like Pokemon Snap, so this could be interesting. I doubt the sea life will be quite as much fun as Pokemon itself. But oh, Sierra. I know this logo. It's the studio logo I saw a lot when I was a kid. Don't know Wanako, though, or Wild Tangent. These are all... Actually, no, I do know that. I recognize that W. The Wild Tangent logo I'm familiar with looks different than that. Anyway, we'll just do a single player here, looks like. Got a coral reef. Ship graveyard, which would be cool if it was locked. Deep sea, abyss, volcano. Okay, so it looks like coral reef is our only option. There's 36 stars and 10 seashells. Photos of the backs or bottoms of the creatures score lower than their heads or faces. Okay, so that's good to know. Each solo has 10 collectible gold shells. Use your gizmo to collect them all. Okay, we're going to take the cub out for a run in the coral reef where you'll learn the basics of underwater photography in a short tutorial. That's exciting. This little Santa's elf-looking guy here will give us the rundown. So, okay. I think I can probably figure this out. Why did it move up? Okay, alright, so I got a photo of the fish. Okay, so I can use the zoom in. This? Okay. Yeah, look at that. Okay. Just get different reactions by throwing gizmos at them. Okay. So, like, this is like apples, and this really is just like Pokemon Snap. Alright, so I can... Yeah. So, don't forget to take a photo with... Yeah. Yeah, I get it. Okay, so yeah, it really shows the personality of the fish. Okay, so that's our tutorial. Now we can actually play it. Oh, that fish was a ghost the whole time! Alright, so now we can pull him around and... Oops, I didn't mean to take that. I wanted to see. Oh, hey, there's a big one. Do I have like an unlimited number of gizmos? I don't see anything counting them. This guy is... Oh, there we go. Look how surprised he is, I love it. Okay, this seems like fun. Like a little... The only problem is it's really slaggy when it comes to, like, actually taking the photo. Like, I click it and it's like a full, like, 2 or 3 seconds later when it actually takes the picture. It makes it hard to get the photo you want. I don't know why there's such a delay there. But other than that, this seems pretty cool, honestly. Like, it's not a great game or anything, but, like, for like, a little silly thing for kids to play with, I got two of them there. There we go. so I've taken 8 of 12 photos now. I'm just clicking away, because it's hard to get, like, the perfect photo the first try, because of how, like, long it delays. Turn around. Hey, look at me. Look at me, I'm trying to take your picture here, you yellow thing. Can't do it. Can't get it to look at you. Like, he does his little dance when I hit him with the gizmo, but... There we go. Okay, whatever. Let's see. Oh, we got some seahorses. That's pretty cool. And the swordfish? Yeah. I like how expressive these fish are. Like, they're less like... I was worried that they'd be, like, really realistic. And they are for the most part, but they're closer to like Finding Nemo characters, where they're realistic looking, but they're also like really expressive and have human emotion in their expressions. So let's see, he's gonna rate my photos. Looks like okay, move to highlight the photo and then A to select. Okay, so like I liked this one. It wasn't centered, but Wait, it wants me to pick the one that's most centered? I can do that. Okay. I thought it was just wanting me to pick my favorite one. But these aren't even my photos, are they? Okay. Select the photo that has the most interesting reaction. Probably this one. Yeah, I don't need the... This part's... I don't know. I guess for kids, but... one with the best sea life facing the camera? Probably this one. Okay. Shows good detail, but not too close. I like this one. Yeah, okay. That one, that turtle, I was talking about Finding Nemo, it kind of reminds me of that. Okay, okay. Not quite what he's looking for. Yeah, there's no fish in that one. I was just, I accidentally clicked that one while trying to... Yeah, the creature's too far away. Yeah, I'm surprised they even registered there was a creature in it at all. Okay, so it's an... which is a bit far away. Yeah. Okay. Let's see. Nice clownfish photo. Creature's, yeah, way too far away. I forgot about the zoom entirely, honestly, while playing. He's rating all of my photos, but... yeah, the photo's a bit boring. Yeah. Found a new creature. Nice crab photo. Great use of the zoom. The creature is just the right size. Choice of the angle. You can really appreciate the features of the fish. Yeah. Got some good action. Creature's properly centered. This is my best picture, probably. Oh, wait. He likes this one even better, it says. I guess because there's a second one. I think there was... I like this one. Yeah, he likes the old one better, but, let's see. It's okay at this size. Nice. I just like that they look like they're dancing. Nice regal angel photo. A bit far away. Choice of angle. Yeah, yeah. So yeah, it keeps track of, like, one photo, like, my best photo for each type of fish that I take a picture of. So, like, if I took a better photo of this fish, it would replace it. Just like that. There. Even though I was trying to get the seahorses with that one. Okay. So anyway, that's the game. Took a little bit longer than I would like to look at all those, but let's go ahead and move on to the arcade. We've got some interesting follow-ups to this one. This was a nice little cooldown before we get into what I expect to be a little bit weird. Yeah. Alright, so now we're getting into some of the stuff I'm not really sure what to expect from. This is Happy Tree Friends. The wickedly weird cartoon series goes interactive. Try it now. Okay. And I mentioned earlier, we did get a video for this playing in the corner of a previous demo reel. I was just playing the trailer for it. If you don't know what Happy Tree Friends is, it's a web series where they take really cute, like, kid-friendly-looking animal characters and then murder them as brutally and violently as they can manage. So there's a tutorial, but let's just go into the story mode. I don't know what the game's going to be like. Like, I can imagine what it'll look like, but I don't know what we're going to actually play. Well, this is really quiet. The audio here is a lot quieter than the rest of the disc. So right now it's just playing an episode, basically. I don't know the Happy Tree Friends characters by name, like I recognize most of them, but anyway. So far it doesn't look like anyone's died. This one's about to, yeah, see there we go. So if this is too much for you, you should probably skip ahead right now. This is not going to get any better. I don't know what exactly is going to happen in this demo, but that's not the worst I've seen from Happy Tree Friends, in all honesty. So right now, the squirrel's just going crazy. I don't know. Oh, okay, he's reformed, I guess. All right, off on his merry way. Oh, but those raccoons are back. Okay. Is there a game in here? Is the Happy Tree Friends game just playing episodes? Okay, see, now they're offering him video games, which I guess are more addictive than candy. Okay. I get it, because we're playing the game, right? I guess. So is that the setup here? Okay. Let's finish early. To see the whole movie, you must complete all the zones and earn at least one gold or in the junkyard. Go on, Lumpy needs all the help he can get. Okay, so we have to, like, unlock more of the episodes, I guess? I don't know why you'd... like, I don't know what kind of motivation that is. You can watch Happy Tree Friends online for free anytime you want. But here we go, this is the actual game. I was hoping it would look like the cartoons, but it looks like they actually made it 3D here. They're showing us the whole level. So I guess it's just, like, a platformer? I'm assuming... hold on. What do I do? So I've got... okay, wait. What am I supposed to be doing? Like, I froze some of them there. Am I supposed to be helping them or hurting them? I honestly don't know with the way this game is. Or with the way the franchise is, I should say. So, okay, I can... I guess I just interact with the environment and try to... I'm assuming I want to help them get through. Again, this one's way quieter. I don't hear any sound right now, but, like, the Soul Calibur trailer and stuff on the other... on the menu of the disc, I should say, were really loud. So, hold on. What does this do? Do I need to put out... Okay, I put out the fire there. Okay, that does something else. Can they get through? I can't even see what's blocking them. It doesn't look like anything is. Okay. Well, they're just trying to go through too fast. Oh, did one of them lose the front of their face, it looks like? Okay, so, no, that's not what I want. Hold on. Maybe, okay, freezing that helped them somehow. Okay. I'm gonna keep moving along. Yeah, it looks like they've lost body parts and stuff. Probably from, like, closing the door in their faces and things like that. I guess I just need to keep this up until they get across. So, this is the game, I guess. Just helping the tree friends get through this thing and then looking at the injuries they receive while it's going on. I don't know. Let's get all of them on here at once. So I lost track of our porcupine friend over there. Looks like she's doing okay. There we go. Come on, guys. Just keep on moving along. I don't know. This isn't really working for me, but, I can't seem to stop these swords. I don't know what I'm supposed to do about these. I don't know. I guess I could try to, like, stop the tree friends somehow? But, anyway. Let's see. I need to... What am I doing here? Okay, just opening the door, I guess. And let's make it through, okay. They did it. I guess if you were wanted to hurt them, you could do stuff to try to damage them more. Like, all of my injuries that came through were accidental. I guess that's it. Okay, that's all we do. Brand new, unseen, two-part Happy Tree Friends movie. Original gameplay in 30 levels. 10 unique themed environments. So, yeah, that's the game. I don't get it. Like, if you like the show, whatever, you can watch it. I don't see the appeal of this game, honestly. But let's go ahead and move on. We've got another game I don't know why exists, so we're going to try out here. Next up here we have the Penny Arcade Adventure. Webcomic stars Gabe and Tycho wield guns and fists in a satisfying RPG-style romp. Oh, all right. Like with Happy Tree Friends, this is an video game adaptation of, like, an internet property or something that's largely on the internet. Although I think Happy Tree Friends and Penny Arcade have both made it to other more, like, quote-unquote official media. Like, I think Penny Arcade's been published and Happy Tree Friends is on, like, Netflix or something. I'm not positive about those things, but I think I've heard that. I'm not a huge fan of either franchise. Like, I read Penny Arcade when I was in, like, high school, and I guess I thought it was funny at the time, but it didn't really hold my interest, humor-wise.
Four gods wait on the windowsill, where once eight gods did war and will. And if the gods themselves may die, what does that say for you and I?
Okay, I guess, was that supposed to be, like, deep? I'm assuming it's meant to be, like, a parody of how an RPG usually starts, but... It's a robot humping the inside of a jar there. Okay. I don't know anything about this game. I didn't know there was a Penny Arcade game before this disc. So, I don't know what to expect. It doesn't seem, so far, like it's trying to be like the comic. It looks like it's just using the characters in a whole different thing than what they do in the comics. In the comic, they just sit around on a couch and play video games. At least that's what I remember of it. I'm just gonna play a trial here, start an empty slot, that's fine. It opened up, I'm probably gonna cut it out, but it opened up my selecting which device to save on, so it's gonna create a save here. It's always weird to me when demos create save files. It's more 3D looking than I was expecting, but it looks like we have character creation? Hold on, how does this work? Test my body. I can change between two genders here, and we'll keep this one. What kind of body shape can we get? Just like, is it just two? Okay, we'll go with that one. When the character moves to cover the face with their hands, it makes it hard to see what the change was. So again, there's only two. So there's not a lot of customization. But honestly, I wasn't expecting it to be any. I thought we'd just be playing one of the main characters, but it looks like we're gonna be our own little character here. So let's go with that. It's cute. It's cute, right? I don't see the changes in the eyebrows. Look, we just got wide open eyes or like half-lidded eyes. I like how sassy she looks like that. Only one pair of glasses to choose from. We'll go without this. Normally I like glasses, but I didn't like the way those ones sat on this face. They look weird, don't they? They're too high, I think is the problem. And just a frowny mouth and a happy mouth. We'll go with the frowny one. Okay. And clothes. We get to choose these two. Alright, I like that. Yeah, that matches. I'm getting a little bit ready to just jump in. Normally I would have a lot of fun with customization. Oh, okay. I see why I can do the color now. But we'll just go with the default colors for now. It's not like I'm going to be able to like keep this and play this character for a long time. So just for the purpose of the demo, we'll have this character with the default colors. If I was going to play this game for real and actually cared, I'd probably spend like 20, 30 minutes on the character alone. Not on screen, probably, if I was Let's Playing it. But for this, this is fine. So now we're going to get to see the RPG-style adventure that was advertised. It looks like it's set in Victorian England, maybe? Or something similar to that. I don't know. Took a really long time to load there. I'm going to have to just cut that out. Like, at least twice as long as what I'm going to keep in the episode. But now we have a cutscene. I wish the whole game was like this, kind of like with Happy Tree Friends. I don't know how hard it is to make like a 2D game like these versus the 3D models. Both this and Happy Tree Friends I think would have been a lot better serviced by being 2D if they could have. But anyway, now we get to see our character here animated, which is pretty neat. It reminds me kind of the, we played a space adventure game, we gotta make your own character.
The sun rises over your perfect life, in your perfect neighborhood, on this perfect morning, in the mostly perfect burg of New Arcadia. I say mostly perfect because from the edge of the city to its black heart, it pulses with evil. But we may be getting ahead of ourselves. I am here to guide you through this corrupted suburbia. While we surmount these challenges, do not dwell on my mysterious identity. It will only distract you from the task at hand. You're dwelling on it, aren't you? I urge you, do not. Your life and the lives of others may well depend upon it. Now then, forgive me. I'm afraid that I cannot concentrate with your lawn in such disarray. Please, pay me this small kindness. Take up yon rake and bring these grounds in line with civilization. I beg you.
Okay, so we've got a rake. But, like, look how much better we looked in 2D than we do now. The character just looks better. the art style looks better in two dimensions, but I went to interact and this is what we get. Okay. Just, alright. I thought there would maybe be gameplay, but it just activated a cutscene here. I like that it's a comic, I guess, since that's what we're adapted from. It doesn't seem to have a whole lot to do with that comic, or at least what I know of it. I'm not like a huge fan or anything, I just remember reading it for a while when I was in high school, but... there's a robot, I guess? It's... okay. Stepped in my house. I don't know why I need to worry about the lawn if this was going to happen. But, yeah, there it goes. The Iron Giant just wandering away. Alright. We look pretty upset about it. I don't blame us. I'd be upset too. And then... oh, there's the characters from the comic. It's still weird to me we play an OC in this game. Like, I don't really mind, because it's not like I like the main characters, and I like character creation in games. As a rule of thumb, that's usually a selling point for me.
Things are worse than I imagined.
Okay.
I thought we had all afternoon, at least. We're even going to go windsurf, weather permitting. There is no time to mourn, however. We must direct ourselves toward more useful endeavors. For example, that was a rather large robot. And it was being followed by two strange men. Let us chart the winding course of our destiny. What say you?
Okay. So, yeah, let's do this, disembodied voice. Okay. Let's begin our dark work. Okay.
That's the spirit! Onward! Cry havoc and let slip the dogs of... the dogs of... I know this. Cry havoc, and then you do something to some kind of dog. Curse it. Well, we best be on our way. I'm sure it will come to me eventually.
Yeah. Let's slip the dogs of war. It's very funny. He didn't remember.
Take heed, pupil. These creatures are a recent phenomenon in New Arcadia. Their carnal appetite for fresh fruit drives them to tiny acts of vulgarity.
Yeah, okay. That's one of the robots we saw in the opening. We're talking to it a bit. They just talk in code there, so... alright, so press the corresponding button to imitate the combat action. Okay, so... What am I doing? I can't go to the ones that are actually there. So, okay, I don't know how that worked. Something weird happened there. Okay. Alright, I kind of get it. Okay, and then... it just peed on me, I guess? Well... okay, we can do this again, I guess. It's one down. Pull the retro, just pour any... oh, okay. That would have been good to know before. You killed FFMO. Okay. Oh, there we go. It's gone. Okay, no more humping robots. We can move on. That was... not the best battle system, but maybe if I got used to it, it'd be more fun. I don't know. Lots of people running around scared.
A cat.
Where?
It appears to be beckoning you thither. To speak to the cat, simply approach him and press A.
Okay. Hello, cat. Okay. I'm wanting... let's meow with the cat. Sure. Okay. Purr and meow simultaneously. Apparently stumble on some kind of cat insult. Okay. Hold on, let's meow. Let's try meowing the other way. Let's gently at it. Okay. Jilly make it T Kemper. Okay. So I got a cat. Alright. By meowing at it. Seems legit. Is it gonna follow me now, or... what?
Okay, it'll just sit there until it's needed. So, oh, hey, there's those two guys.
Those strange men again.
Yeah.
We will make their acquaintance soon.
Sometimes it lets me wander around while he's talking, and sometimes it doesn't.
Once they held wholesome milk, known to promote bone health. Now they keep a sinister secret.
It looks like milk to me.
Let us discover this secret.
Oh. Okay. So, I guess we're doing this again. Alright. I don't know what that bottom one is. The A button? I don't know what it is. Whenever I select it, I think it's like maybe an item. It brings up an empty inventory though. I can't seem to get why. It doesn't look like it charges. Alright. Maybe it does. Guys have to wait. But it doesn't seem to do anything. So we'll just ignore that and just keep hitting with the rake for now. Maybe the Y is like a special attack I haven't unlocked, or I have to have some other condition met in order to do it right. In the meantime, we'll just keep hitting these humping robots. They're tiny acts of vulgarity, as was stated. Well, let's try this cat attack and see what it does. Didn't do anything, okay.
I must say that I expected more from our feline companion.
It didn't, it just sat there and looked at itself. Okay. Got some more experience and some items, looks like. See, it seems like pretty typical RPG fare. Let's see. Just done with a weird style. Like, I like the humor more or less. Like, it's not super funny so far, but it's trying. That's good. And some of it's kind of funny, at least amusing, I guess, even if it's none of it's been laugh out loud funny so far.
A truly complete diet always includes fresh seasonal fruits. We should collect some from that nearby tree.
Okay. Over here? It's moving me for me.
To interact with an item, approach it carefully. When an icon appears, press A.
So I got some fruit to distract the robots with. Okay. But I can't get the ones in the tree. Just, okay. Whatever. I can inspect these other things too. That's good. Let's see. Oh, there's more robots. Okay. So, weakness with fruit. So yeah, I can distract them. I don't know if it's necessary. They haven't posed a threat so far. But I do have an item now for the first time since we started playing, so that's kind of good. Put that one down. And this one will take two hits as well. I get it down to just one hit, so if I level up, I probably will be able to take on one hit, I would assume. It says you can level up your weapons in the full game. I haven't had that option yet. But I leveled up myself, so my attack went up by one. So yeah, I should be able to knock him out in one hit now. Got the Grand Slam. Okay. We'll see.
You are progressing even faster than I thought possible. Will it be fast enough, I wonder?
Fast enough.
As you gain experience defeating enemies, your power grows. Already you have earned a potent new ability, and I have faith you'll soon have an opportunity to use it.
Okay. 3 stories tall. All right, so for a second I thought it was ending there. But it looks like we got some boxes here. Bandages in them. Okay, and it looks like, are those our main characters over there? Wait. You'd hit what? It's gonna hit me. Oh, and I got my new attack now. Hold on. I should have used it there. Okay. So we'll try doing the full thing here. Man, it takes it a long time to load. Look how long it took us to get just the X attack there. Now we get beat on again. Oh, it was a critical hit. Ah, gross. These nasty little buggers. Alright. There we go. Okay. So, hold on. It's not working right. Ready. I don't know what I did. I didn't get it. Okay. I missed something there with how that was supposed to work. That's okay. We'll try just hitting this one normally, I guess. I don't need to do the big grand slam on every. It said I could hit multiple ones at once, but it didn't happen. I'm also still not knocking them out in one hit. I guess they leveled up too. Anyway, slow that one down. Okay. Yeah, like this is. I don't know. I don't want to like be too critical of this because it. Like, it seems fine, but it's also, like, not really very fun so far. Like, the battle system is a little bit too slow. Like, I like turn-based battles fine, but I don't know. I'm just having a hard time getting into it for some reason, but I don't hate anything here. It's just not holding my interest. So, now we're at an elementary school? Okay. This guy's... Like, he was stuck on me for a second. I was trying to talk to him, but it wouldn't let me there. Oh, the robots are coming, okay. The NPCs don't say a whole lot.
The fellows who ran after that hulking contraption! What knowledge have they gleaned from that Great Depression? No doubt created by its gigantic foot module. Perhaps we should ask them. Go on, don't be shy. They seem nice. Well, that one seems nice.
Okay. I didn't see the NPC there. I thought this guy was saying that. Okay, it's not a Yeti print. No? Okay. They're arguing over whether it was a Yeti. So I don't remember if this was in time. I assume that's what the humor in the comic was like. I really don't remember that well. So I'll just say hello. Punch devils. So okay. Yeah, what a couple of assholes. Yeah, hello. Yeah, let's just say who are you guys, I guess. Tycho Bray. I don't actually know these characters' names. And John Gabriel. Okay. So I got a card. Okay. So you're tracking the robot? It's not an official case or anything. You might call it professional curiosity. Insurance purposes. Okay. Alright. So they saw me with my mouth agape. Yeah. Alright. So I've been avoiding the is this normal for you? But yeah. So giant robots are fairly normal. Okay. So I don't know. This feels like supernatural, I guess, is what I should be referencing. Just the way they're talking. Okay. So we can come along for vengeance purposes. Okay, so I'm now a party member of the detective agency. Again, none of this has anything to do with what I remember from the comics. Which is fine, it's just I'm not sure why this is a Penny Arcade game. I guess the humor is Penny Arcade-ish, but anyway. Maybe this is all based on something in the comic from a point that I wasn't reading, but... okay, so... I'm still playing, okay. I keep thinking that it's gonna end. But now I've got, like, a whole party, we can fight some more robots. Yeah, we've got everybody here now, look at this. Okay, how does this work? Okay, I'm trying to hit all of them there, okay. So I got overkill, okay. Alright, I thought, for some reason when it was describing that attack, I thought hitting all of the points would make me hit more than one enemy, but I guess not. Let's try doing a strong attack here. Was this button mashing while the timer runs out? Okay. Oh, there was a second one, and I wasn't ready for it. Okay. So, yeah. It's not able to take it out because of that. Okay, we can have our last attack here. Oh good, a critical hit wasted on something with 1 HP. Alright, and then we'll just see what this guy's regular attack is. Like in just punching robots, I guess. Okay. So we did it. Yeah, good job, everybody. Yeah, they're all a higher level than me. That's great. Okay. So I can fight different enemies and talk to new characters in the full game. It just stops to tell me that, but then it lets me keep playing. It keeps telling me these things that usually they tell you at the end of the demo. It's like, hey, this is all the stuff you didn't get to do. But now we're at Desperation's End. There's a gas station over there. I guess we should... Oh, there's some over here, too. They keep hitting on me. Okay. So... I guess I can do an attack here. Yeah, this is what I'm talking about it being just kind of... I don't know. It's just a little boring so far. I don't know. That part of that might just be taste. Like, for me, these, like, turn-based RPG-type games can be fun, but usually more for the story than the gameplay. That's just me. But, here, the story's just kind of nonsense. Like, it's supposed to be. That's not really a criticism, but I'm not invested in the story or the characters. And that's really the only reason why I would get too involved in an RPG like this, is because I want to see those characters and the story develop. Like, that's why I played Okage, because Okage used a turn-based battle system. It was a more fun one than this, because it didn't rely so much on, like, timing and doing things like that. But it was still, like, a turn-based battle. And I liked that game quite a bit, mostly because I really liked the characters and the story. But here, it isn't drawing me in quite as quickly as that game did. And that game was also like a comedy. It was also like an amusing, funny game with quirky, silly characters. But it just did it way better. This game is like... It's quirky enough that I know it's supposed to be funny, but nothing's really been funny. Haha. Okay.
And to think, I had such plans. Plans that would have taken the fall once our windsurfing was concluded.
What are you talking about?
There is no time. Okay. I send a mewling babe to battle steel devils on the rain-slick precipice of darkness. Well, I suppose it can't be helped. Let me leave you with this, at least. Your new friends have granted you a refuge in their supernatural agency. You may access it at any time by pressing the Y button. From here, you may travel about the city, examine your inventory, and research the current case. You might start by selecting the map and visiting a young woman by the name of Anne Claire. Charming girl. And with that, I wish you luck. And faith. And time.
Okay. So, now we're talking about the logo? It's like an eyeball gear, right? So, yeah, I don't care about this. Alright, so we got the new case, new map area. So, I guess we're done with, like, the demo portion, and now we can just kind of do whatever. Hold on, I wanted to see I wanted to talk to the person he told us about, but I guess... Wait. How do I... Okay, so we got... There's our cat. It's my unidentified support characters. No... Nothing here. Okay. Well, he said I could talk to her, but I guess not. So... We can just keep wandering around, I guess. I'm trying to decide how much more I like. If there's more to the, okay, we go in Claire's room. This is what I wanted to see, and then we'll probably call it quits. I just wanted to meet a character that wasn't one of those two guys, and we get another 2D scene, which is neat. Like, this is probably my favorite part of the game so far: these little cartoon cutscenes, even though they aren't doing anything so far. This is kind of charming, I guess. More so than the gameplay is. And I like getting to see my my character in 2D. I don't know why this is really fun for me. But I guess now we're just going to get a... Instead of actually going to meet Anne, we'll get just getting like a cutscene of stuff. And yeah, all of this is making the game look more interesting than what we played. Which again, was for me kind of boring, but I don't hate it. It's just hard for me to imagine taking time out of my day to play it. And it brought me back here. So can I go to Anne Claire's room, or... Like, it played a trailer, like the demo... Okay, it's doing it again. You know what, here, let's just, we'll go ahead and quit out now, and I will see you guys at the last demo here. Okay, our last game here is Schizoid. Join up with a friend in this co-op space shooter built expressly for two. Uh-oh. That could be a problem here. I don't do too well with games built explicitly for two. We played Army of Two, and I ended up having to play both of them by myself, so I couldn't get anyone to come play with me. If that's the case here, and this is something I need a partner for, I might look and see if I can grab someone. I just don't know. We'll see what happens. If I think I can get away with playing by myself, I will. So let's just play Schizoid. Yeah, local co-op's turned off right now, because I don't have another controller, but, hold on, what is Wingman Bot Training? Let's try this. Maybe it'll let me do some single player here if I'm just playing, like, if the comm's playing the other one? Okay, I'm the blue ship, avoid red enemies, touch the blue enemies to burst them. Okay, so is this a blue enemy? Alright. Okay, so that's it? Okay, this is working, I guess. Okay, attack enemies of the same color, avoid enemies of the opposite color. So, alright. There we go. Okay, so, yeah, this is fine. This is kind of fun after playing the last couple of games were kind of boring. This is, you know, not crazy exciting or anything, but it's interesting. It's kind of fun. So I guess, The way the game's meant to be played, somebody else will be playing the other one. I don't know. I don't know what just happened there for starters. I don't know what that was about. Come on. I can't catch this one. There we go. Okay. So level cleared. One life lost. Okay, I don't know what I did to lose a life. I didn't notice myself lose a life. It looked like the other guy lost a life. Maybe that... If this is supposed to be co-op, maybe that counts. In the meantime, let me just nab all of these, I guess. Oh, he already cleared out some of these, so I can just start going through them here. Now we've got a couple that are turning into scorpions. Oh, this guy's chasing me now. What is going on there? Okay. So again, it looked like he died. I don't know what happened. Okay, so yeah, I guess he's supposed to represent the other player character. That would normally be another human, so I'm supposed to also be protecting him by attacking the other blue enemies, I guess. Okay, so there's an infinity chapter that says on there, which I guess is just a never-ending level until you die. Okay. Anyway, there. That was easy. That one was really easy. I'm assuming something else was supposed to happen if I didn't get there fast enough, but we just... Okay. So let's see. Yeah, I can go straight through the other ship. That's good to know. I had been also avoiding it. That red star just closed in on me. Okay. So the blue star is way down here. I have to get to it. Come on. Come on, little guy. There we go. Okay, I got it. So yeah, this seems like fun, and assuming the two-player works the way I think it does, where the other person is playing this other ship that can't hurt me, then this seems like a really fun little game. God, I cannot get away from that star at all. Jesus. They're all over the place, look at this. Okay. See if I can get... Those scorpions look like they were fighting each other. Oh boy, okay. Come on now. We've lost a lot of lives here. Come on. God! Damn it! Just cannot get away from them fast enough. Okay. So, there we go. Got it. 5 lives lost, jeez. That one was hard. We got a lot of lives for beating it, though. But, yeah, if I want to play this with, like, a friend or... even like my sisters or something, I could see this being pretty fun. And maybe that part of that's just because I really did not care for the games we just played. Neither of those the Happy Tree Friends or Penny Arcade were especially bad. They were just really boring and unfun to play, and I didn't realize quite how unfun or how little fun I was having playing them until I played this for comparison. This is... Jeez, I'm sorry, I didn't know you were going to go that way, or I would have cleared this in first. Okay, so there. Got... Okay, yeah, all those little eggs hatch into things eventually if you don't get them fast enough, I guess. So everything else is up to my partner now, right? There's no more blue ones. I'm just waiting on him to get the last red one and trying not to get killed. There we go, okay. But yeah, like, and this isn't even anything amazing. It's like a really simple little game, but it's fun, which is more important than... Because, like, those other games were, like, they were... had more going on. Like, they appeared to have more, elements to them, I guess. But they were not fun to play, I guess, is all I'm trying to say. Okay, so how does this work? Okay, I have to, like, clear a path for him, by taking in the blue things it's launching out. Okay, this is... Wow, this one requires a lot of teamwork for... I'm glad that the AI here is pretty smart. I just have to... Okay. There we go. We did it! Okay. So, in the full game, you'll encounter the razor wire power for the first time in this next one. Okay, I wonder what that means. Okay. Bring the razor wire to the other hero, it says. Okay, so what does that do? Wait, oh. It creates... What is this? Huh. This is interesting. Okay. Cool. That was kind of fun. So I got an achievement. Interesting. Okay, so yeah, I'm not gonna unlock the full game just to get that achievement. But I'm having fun playing this. I wonder how many levels we get to do here, because it's had quite a few. Anyway, so now we've got... Is this razor wire again? I can't catch up to my partner. Okay. Crap, crap, crap. I can't catch him. Like, he was just moving too fast. Whatever. Okay. So, there, we cleared out some of these. There, I think that's what we were supposed to do, but I got killed again. Jeez. Okay. Alright, well, we did it anyway. I think that level would be really easy if I could have talked to the other person. But he just kept going off, and I didn't know what he was doing. Okay, so let's see. We've got, got zeroed in on there. Okay, come on, clear out some of these. Boy, we're fucked. This is a hard level. Look at all this. Like, they're just clumped so close together. It's hard for us to even like get the ones that we can get. Look at all these red ones here. I can't do anything about that. Okay. Oh boy, alright, if I can just get this guy. Nope! I'm a real Uber gamer. Alright, if you're a real Uber gamer, try Uber Schizoid. Okay. So yeah, there's some of the. Your brain will never be the same, I don't know about that. But let's see, so is. What is Uber Schizoid here? Both ships at the same time with left and right sticks. Oh wow, okay, so yeah. Let's try this until I die. Probably won't take as long as the last one did. I'm pretty sure I'll die really quickly here. Right. So with the right analog stick, I control the red ship, and with the left one, I control the blue ship. So I was talking about communicating with the other person. Now I am the other person. I'm glad this is a mode that's available. This is pretty cool. Oh boy, but it's hard. I'm already fucked. There we go. Okay, got it. Yeah, this is not something I could do. I could do this if I had a lot of practice. Since this is my first time trying this, it's really hard for me to split my attention the way that I need to. Okay. Crap. I'm not even on the same part of the screen all the time. Whoa, I'm all mixed up here. Okay, crap. Okay. I have no idea what I'm doing. Okay. Wait, was that the wrong color? Ugh, boy. What are those things? Do those things hurt no matter what? I can't tell what color they're supposed to be. I'm losing all of my lives on this level, but I think... There we go. Yeah, I don't know what those little suns are. I remember seeing them, but I don't remember what them doing anything different. I don't remember them being that dangerous, I guess. Okay, so hold on. Let's see if I can do this. This is gonna be hard. So we're gonna all start moving here in a second. Crap! That was dumb. That was dumb of me. I'm an idiot. Okay. No. I got my thumbs mixed up. What am I doing? Okay. Oh boy. This is bad. This is really bad. Yeah, there we go. Game over. I just kept getting turned around too often. But yeah, that was hard. Some of them, like the razor wire one, would be really easy doing it like that, but the ones where they're all over the place, I kept, like, you'd be looking at one corner of the screen and you'd forget which thumb was doing which, and I just go flying into them. Anyway, that's it for this episode, though. That's our last demo here. I haven't tried two-player co-op, but that's because I don't have anyone to play with, sorry. I can imagine what it's like, though, and I'm sure that's probably the best way to play it. Yeah, Schizoid was fun. I'd never heard of it. I messed up something there. Anyway, I've never heard of this, but I thought it was a lot of fun. At least partly because of what we had played before this. But I think even independent of that, I think this was pretty fun little thing. So, yeah, that's it for us this week. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. I had a lot of fun this episode, especially early on here. Civilization and Dragon Ball Z were both really fun for me. Even Battlefield wasn't as painful as I thought it would be. It was kind of fun. NASCAR was whatever in the arcade years. Surprisingly, the two games I didn't know what were going in, both of them were really fun. These two that I recognized the brands of were whatever. But Sea Life Safari was actually pretty fun. I wouldn't mind more like modern takes on the game like Pokemon Snap, like that one was. And Schizoid, like I said, was a lot of fun. But if you liked this episode, come on back next week. We'll play another disc. I don't know yet what it'll be, but whatever it is, I'm sure we'll have fun playing it together, and I hope I'll see you guys there. Bye. Thank you.
Excalibur 4.